Hope y'all like the One Piece episode. I might release episode 2 tonight if I'm able to get it there. But first, let's jump right into Baki. Let's end this right here, right now. Oh, no, you don't. So he did teach him. Your palm.
There. Now let's do it in the opposite order. Starting with your index finger, fold them in. Then close your thumb over them. Now, what have you got? It's strength, son. You've got strength in your hand. You can punch with that strength. You can pierce with that strength. It's humanity's oldest and finest weapon. The fist.
Release the tension from your folded fingers and gently hold them in place with your thumb. Don't be worried about your stance. Let your body tell you where your fist should be.
I see. You haven't forgotten.
This is where it all began. The first lesson my father gave me.
Hey, boss. There's only like a couple dozen people between us and the action. You want me to clear a path?
No.
No. Here is fine. Don't think about defending yourself. Concentrate your weight on the ball of your forward foot. Focus only on throwing the punch. Everything else is a distraction. Pull all that you are into that fist. There is no will it work. Or won't it work? The thought doesn't even cross your mind. That is what a test of strength is like. The sound of knuckles hitting faces. It was the loudest and most horrible noise the two of them had made all night.
Get back in there, Baki. Folding.
Keeping oneself out of danger while defeating the enemy. That is the art of fighting. That is technique. But to cast off any thought of protecting the most vital spots of one's body, and to instead willfully expose them to the blade, that is not a fighting art, nor a martial art.
It's just a slugfest.
A test of strength. A test of masculinity.
Excuse me. Who is this man?
What's going on?
I can't see.
Who is that?
So is it. It really is the ogre.
What's he doing?
Praying?
Hey, you notice something? Yeah, it seems like a lot of people from foreign countries just showed up.
The hell?
Either one of them's giving an edge. It's a battle between the strongest guys in the world.
Reminds me of someone.
Going toe to toe with Ogre. Who knew there was someone fool enough to do that?
Oh, man. I don't believe this. The kid's in a full-on slugfest with Yujiro Hanma.
Oh, show us.
Well, you know, boss, we could get a little closer.
No. Here is fine.
They made it to the front.
They're already at the front.
You can feel it coming. One way or the other, with this insane flurry of punches is finally over. This fight will be over too.
The teeming masses. Weak and helpless. In front of them, shielding them, stood an Oni. Behind him, masses of the weak gathered and huddled. There was always a great crowd of them. And always, always threatening the weak, there were, yes, strong soldiers.
Nazi.
Made up his mind.
his place was always to be facing the strong.
Even though Yujiro never meant it, he protected a lot of people.
There is no evil. There is only strength. Eventually, the leaders of even the greatest of nations, perceiving his strength, were forced to recognize him as their equal. They called him Ogre. More than their equal, in fact, they cowered before his strength and sought to appease him with extraordinary monetary rewards. The masses, seeing him triumphant over the powerful nations that had for so long driven them to despair, worshipped him as a god and loved him as an angel. The ring separating father and son from the crowd had gradually shrunk in size. The field of energy from this epic battle had drawn them in. They wanted to be near it, to feel it up close, to engrave it into their minds. The son's fists felt his father. The father's fists felt his son. Again and again their fists flew, seeking the most effective angle. Again and again their feet hammered the ground, searching for greater leverage. A domestic dispute like no other. He was captured by news cameras and cell phones and transmitted to living rooms and computer screens across the nation.
Dad, are you watching this?
He's in front.
Competition makes me wonder. In this match, whose victory do I even wish for?
Big Jack? Still doping?
That should have been me in there!
It seems a shame to be doing it with our fists. What if I punch him as if it were a hug?
It's over. He's done.
My dad is amazing. How many times tonight have I thought he's amazing?
Just like his mama. Boy, you're just like your mama. He's done.
Subcutaneous bleeding throughout the body. The brain and internal organs showing signs of
shutting down.
That's enough, son.
You went too far, bro.
Yes, enough. To throw another punch, to continue the carnage, that wouldn't be a fight. That wouldn't be the great brute.
Thank you!
You're incredible!
It was an honor to watch you fight!
Such an honor!
Thank you!
Yo, get an ambulance for my boy!
Time one last kick to the side of the face.
And the Baki fit too. He gave all he had, and even some more now.
All right, then, son. Enough. That's enough.
No. There's no way.
Is that what I think?
It's tofu.
Crowd, too, could see it clearly.
How?
The tofu in his palm as he sliced into it. The leeks as he chopped them on the cutting board. The great brute, Yujiro Hanma, was cooking his specialty. Miso soup with tofu.
Baki, food's ready. Get up.
Guess it's that time.
And as the crowd watched, father and son sat down to the most remarkable midnight snack ever served.
Jack is jealous somewhere.
This is all I've got.
It's more than enough.
Cut it out, will you? Call me Dad.
There. It's right there.
They're in perfect harmony. Okay with doing this here?
Yeah. It doesn't matter where it is.
Relax. Get comfortable. Dig in.
Thanks.
That's wrong. I've noticed it before. You're not holding them properly.
You never taught him, really.
We're back at your 5-star restaurant. Yeah, it's good. Maybe a little too salty.
You wouldn't know how a proper miso soup should taste.
See for yourself. Go on.
Don't be dumb. You know it doesn't taste like anything. It's just make-believe.
I'm about to punch the shit out of him.
They're gone. The bowl and table, they vanished.
Hey, Dad.
You were just saved.
Uh-oh.
What the hell are you saying? That you saved me? Well, you're right. I think I know what it was. That miso soup was a little too salty.
He acknowledged it!
Salty?
All right, I'll come clean. I tried to pull a fast one on you. I lied.
Ogre lied?
You noticed the look of surprise on my face. So you flipped the table and saved me. The essence of strength is this. Having the strength to impose your will and attain your most selfish desires. You made the ogre, the strongest man on earth, go stand in the kitchen.
There is no greater act of selfishness. Right here, claim the title of the strongest in the world.
He claimed Baki stronger. Even though he won the fight, Baki technically lost if you want to say anything.
When all is done, it is he whose head is the highest, the one who is looking down at his opponent. That person is the real champion. Your words, Dad. It was you looking down on me before you walked away. At that moment, I was as good as dead. The fact is, I lost.
He's right.
And therefore didn't know he'd been declared the strongest in the world.
He could say that the strongest in the world.
How about y'all bring him to the hospital now?
Such were the decisive words spoken by the son of the one and only Ogre. A night of surprises. The father handing over the title of world strongest. And the son handing over the victory.
We have
Of course, Tokugawa got down there.
No wonder he's happy. He's as good as new.
Oh, he must have took his treatment.
The greatest father-son fight in history ended right there.
So that's the end. I'll see y'all in the next one. I'm out.